Hello again, ladies and gentlemen. It's my second part of the probably trilogy about Daniel Naroditsky, and not only about him. Yeah, in general, I think it's going to be very interesting. And today, actually, first I wanted to record some statistical one, and only the third, something more entertaining, but decided to change the move order, so to say. And today I'm going to explain you, well, some of my concerns, share with it. It's all based on some games, so there will be some chess here, and also some video recording. Because that was actually the start point of all my past in this anti-cheating story. Yeah, so I remember that because I started to play actually accidentally on chess.com sometime the beginning of 2023, and then I started to play Title Tuesdays probably sometime in March 2023 just for fun. And at the beginning I was naive, I didn't really know anything, so people are playing fantastic games against me, I was taking it normal. Even though I saw that for some reason with others they play much worse sometimes, but at some point started to hit me that it's like a bit too much. That was a game, I mean not even the game, but actually what happened after was like first the first occasion when I really started to investigate, I mean to check statistics, etc. So I want to present you actually the stream of Daniel Naroditsky. So we played in the penultimate round, we were fighting for prizes, maybe we like each of us lost 1 point before that, so it was really like fighting, or maybe 1.5, but basically winning 2 games would be definitely top 3. And I was white against Daniel, I think it was sometime May or June 2023. And okay, he played a fantastic game against me, he beat me convincingly, so nothing really so special. But then, I mean, can happen, yeah, but then I just accidentally fall into his stream. I checked how he played and commented this game, and then the next game, the last round, he won easily, took I think he was second or third finally with 9.5 in this tournament. But somehow, you know, there were some things which I noticed and which were looking very strange to me. I will explain you now, one by one. And then I started to, actually I wrote to chess.com, I said, okay, I'm not like, okay, please check it because it looks really strange. Of course, usually chess.com was not really answering at all my requests. This time they answered and they said, like, okay, no, of course there is, everything is completely clean, without giving any explanation, any factual response to my questions. And then it was somehow not really satisfactory to me, because I would like, when somebody expressing opinion or verdict as chess.com, I would like at least some logical factual explanation. But usually, or practically never, I think I got any from chess.com. Usually they were not answering at all, but this time they answered, but there was nothing factual. So I'm going to share it with you and let's together check what is happening. I mean, I will share with you also my concerns. So this one is, this facing off against Kramnik and winning. Okay, very good. So this is the position. Actually, we both didn't play too well the opening. I was better at some point, but opening is usually, you can afford a lot in the opening, especially in blitz. The most important part is then getting somewhere in the middle of the game. Especially here, I was white, Sicilian, complicated position. Definitely black is already doing well, but it's still a lot of play, here. So it's my move, and let's check the commentary of Dani, and let's check the game. I will stop from time to time and tell my opinion. So I'm playing white, queen a2, knight b3 was threatening, immediately bishop g5, yes, so I would like to stop from this moment on until the end of the game. Only first three lines moves, I mean, vast majority first two lines moves. Can happen still, but so don't hurry to call me paranoid. The whole, you know, the whole story is going to develop further. So, but let's check now. And one thing that was the first time I noticed this, and I will show you some more examples. I noticed a kind of strange eyes behavior. Yeah, again, it can mean different things, but it's really weird. You will see. You will see, especially in, during the next game, because it's very obvious that the chat is here. It's on his left. I mean, you will see that from time to time he would be talking to a chat, and it's on the left. Then what is on the right, where he looks all the time? Monitor is obviously here. It's obviously there. And what can be here on the right? I don't understand. It's for sure. He has, I mean, he's glancing all the time. All the time. Like, especially during the next game. Somewhere which is clearly outside of the monitor. I will show you then an example how it... So I can show you right now. Okay. Let's see. There is, for example, this game. You probably see the board. So you see the clock, okay, your clock is always down, so you look down. Here it's very close to the board. So like, okay, you, especially at that time, now they have another, okay, it can be here, it can be a bit here, but still it's on the same, like, yeah. So just look at me now, as a, I will show you an example. So I am looking at the board and then at the clock. Now at the board, at Black's clock. There is no other point to look anywhere else, but this is outside of the monitor. When I look at this, okay, like that, I'm looking very much up, not on the monitor. Okay, so I guess you see the point. So now let's check how it proceeds. Okay, I will from time to time stop it or make it slow motion that you will see very clearly that there are a lot of glances outside of the monitor. Where? I don't know, it doesn't mean necessarily that there is something wrong in it, but I want an explanation because it's really unusual. I will explain it more later. Okay, so let's see. Let me, because Elmas doesn't speak during now, so he's just playing, and I will from time to time make a slow motion. 1 second, yeah. You see these glances, permanent glances. Okay, let me try to make slow motion. And always first line, all the time. Here, I think like 10 moves in a row, first line. So let's get it in slow motion now. Sorry, some patience that you, okay, queen e7, first line. Let's check, it's a very slow motion, up. This is not monitor. This is nothing to do with the monitor. Monitor is here. It's on the other direction. Okay. Only one can happen, yeah? But look how many of such glances. Again, not monitor. Sorry, this is not a monitor. Where? Where is he looking at? Because the chat... Okay, a bit strange to look so often at the chat. A bit strange, I would say. So let's see, where is the monitor? So monitor is here, straight, yeah? Very straight, so, I mean, 95 first line also. Well, several moves further will be the first line. Again, you see, yeah? Again, there is, okay, let's go a little early. Okay, now, I will just stop, especially when that you will see. Okay, this is not monitor, I'm sorry. This is outside of the monitor. Okay, next. And by the way, you can check if you want my stream, so Anish Giri, there is nothing of this sort, nothing. Because when you play a game, you're concentrated on the position, yeah? You don't really all the time, yeah. You don't glance all the time somewhere outside of the monitor normally. Especially, again, you saw. Now, okay. For the moment, first knight g6, very strong move. I missed first line again. Okay, It's a very slow motion, so in general, he's playing very fast. Okay, now, oppa, again. You saw, there was a short, but quite intense glance up, again. At this side. I'm sorry, but, well, what is he looking at? I mean, even if it was... because it, again, it's always the same direction, yeah? I mean, first of all, it's a very intense situation, very important game. We had both like 40 seconds. Not really time to look at chat, even if you look in the chat, but then later you will see where is the chat and it's not there. It's on the other side, yeah? So how can you explain? I mean, it is very suspicious, actually. I mean, to me, at least to me, yeah, that's why I immediately wrote to chess.com. I said, okay, please check the videos. I mean, what is happening? And Dania, could you explain where are you looking all the time? And you will see this game is really nothing compared to some other, which I'm going to show you further on. Okay, let's see. Again, bishop e5, very strong move. Coming now. Also playing very quick, few seconds per move, all moves first line. Okay. Bishop e5. Now let's see again, a little very quick, but okay, now again. But I'm sorry, clock is not there, and anyways, it cannot be my clock, it cannot be his clock, can be only my clock. And okay, I still have 40 seconds, even if it would be just checking the clock, why to do it permanently? I mean, like, we don't do it, yeah, players, during games. So this and so on and so on. So it continues and continues. Then, okay, then he wins the game. Okay, yeah, also then he plays. Oh, it's always first, second line again. Then, you know, very few third lines. Not a single move which is not top three. Of course, okay, I cannot. For the moment, I still have, you know, I'm still young and I can still improve. But for the moment, I cannot keep up with this level playing blitz. Then also what was quite fascinating, he finds fantastic tactics, which actually was not necessarily, but actually very strong, very clear cut, which is so difficult to see with little time. Okay, let's see here. Yeah, but whenever you stop in few seconds, there will be this glance. I mean, it's like permanent, absolutely permanent. Okay, only the, yeah, so here, this tactics was quite something. Yeah, here, I think this position, it's okay. Sometimes not the first line, but second. But now rook c5 is played, yeah. Yeah, of course I'm lost, I'm trying, but we have not so much time, so I'm trying to, I kind of know, to get some slight counter chance, and I find some little trick here with just 10, 11 seconds. Knight e4, I think I played knight takes b5, rook d7, just to confuse him. Of course, white is completely lost, but just trying to confuse. And then, okay, something completely like, yeah, I didn't see it. Yeah, here you see again, looking there. Not really time, you know, to look outside of the monitor when you have few seconds. Yeah, normally. I mean, normally you're so concentrated on the game, but... here, yeah, he thinks, so I don't know, pretends to think, I don't know. Yeah, rook d7, that was my plan. And now, you see, fantastic, queen h4 check. I mean, it's really, I was just shocked. I thought first it was a mouse leap or something, but then I realized it's a very strong tactics, yeah. And then knight e4, knight d3, and then knight takes c5 after I play king g3, and after knight c5 attacking the rook. I mean, amazing tactics to see in just in 2-3 seconds, and everything works and I'm lost. Okay, so that is still, let's say again, it's not about one particular game, it's about many games. So let's now listen to Dania. He wins the game, even till the end it was all best moves, so sorry, yeah, it was all the best moves, so there is, now it's completely lost, of course, yeah. Some short glances again there. Yeah, not really time with 4 seconds to look outside of monitors, but he still does for some reason. Sorry, there is something with the video. Yeah, now it's totally gone. What is this? Then he's
let's
very
go!
Happy. Yeah, he's very all right. Happy. So now let's see. Now oh, let's see. Good. Yeah, now he starts to look at the chat, yeah?
Yeah, that's freaking right.
Yeah, and
he's misses talking, I can't play with increment.
I don't quite understand. He's talking on the left and on the right, like there and there. So he has chat in two places or what? I don't quite understand this. So now he's checking the game and
Mr. okay. and Mrs. I can't play with increment are silent for once.
Yeah, so no you can. This game okay. is fantastic.
Let's
yes.
win the last one or at
he's
least.
Looking
try.
There, looking there. I don't understand where is the chat.
That
where
was a nice win.
Yeah, it was a nice one. Yeah, now he starts to analyze the game and it's pretty clear the tension.
Yeah, queen
is
h4 is really beautiful.
Yeah, it is.
This
beautiful.
Is just a sexy move. Yeah. I also had rook t5 now.
Yeah,
notice.
Rook d5, it's a second line of engine also. First second line, yeah. Okay.
I mean, so, obviously here he should have taken. I mean, yeah.
No, but here it's totally
I mean, he had some more practical matter. Chances. No, he blundered rook d4, takes it. Yeah,
no,
nice.
I didn't blunder, he just lost, yeah. So now he talks to. He reads the chat, yeah?
Yeah, you there were some nice tactics there.
Yeah, nice tactics. Okay, so I don't understand.
If I win the last one, I get into the top five.
Yeah, I don't understand what is on his right now. Where
get
is
into the
he,
top five.
I mean, what is it? But okay, now the most important thing happened. This was like a. Like introduction, yeah. Now the most interesting thing happened because he's playing the next game, and then I just checked his commentary on the next game, and I can tell you I was shocked because he's still making the best move. He gets completely winning position out of the opening. Again, a lot of glances, you know, on the side, and well, and then the way he commands, the way he doesn't, I mean, it's just he's telling such, I mean, it's not really, because after this level, I mean, after this game, okay, this guy is top five, it's really very top level, and then what he starts to tell when he commands, this is like, okay, this is not even really grandmaster level. So again, I don't understand. I mean, it's like, yeah, this a little bit like this Jekyll and Hyde. Yeah, I mean, what is his level? I mean, and I will tell you more and more in the third part of it. I will again will show you statistically already that it's like all the time a different level. So extremely top, like very very top, and also something really like I can't. Well, it's really not nothing even close to 2700. But still moves are very strong. So let's see. Okay, now he starts to play the next game.
20. Okay, we're playing it to Rizag. I mean, he's obviously beatable.
I don't know what happens with the video, why it is a bit blocked all the time. Maybe my internet, but okay, anyways. So he's, let's come here. Ah, I don't know what happened. So it was...
Jones yeah. played it against okay, so clearly Terizaga looked it up, unfortunately.
Yeah, it plays quick.
We're supposed to go a6 and then d4.
Well, and now, yeah, now again this looks okay. Where is
he
the
didn't
monitor?
Look at him, he's just blocking.
It's also a good question. Where is, I mean, monitor, he's looking down, then he's looking there, and then he's looking there, and the chat is there. So it's just confusing. I mean, like, see, now will be quite interesting moment. I would now make it slow speed, and you will see something a bit like which I didn't. I mean, I would like explanations. I don't, you know, I don't say that something is necessarily wrong, but it's clearly for any unbiased person, it's clearly very unusual behavior, very, very unusual way of, you know, playing chess, let's say. Yeah, so okay, so see now. So this position, black played terribly the opening, now queen a4 is almost winning. But he wants to play knight b5 and then check what happens. Then he changes his mind. So check in the slow motion how does it happen. Okay. I will just stop the sound. Just yeah, so he wants clearly to play knight b5, which is also a good move, but queen a4 is now. He's looking there, very long look, like... I don't know, I mean, it's clear, you know, it's not like when you just, you know, think, calculate, it's different, yeah, the look is intense, like, it's really, you are really watching, you are looking at something, yeah, and then, for quite a while, and then he turns his head, and then he changes the move, and he plays the best move, very quickly, he plays the best move, queen a4, which is practically winning, yeah, which is simply winning. and everything else was like knight b5 was still keeping some advantage, but no more. I mean, yeah, now looking there, and then again there, again to the chat. I mean, it's a bit weird all this. I mean, but okay, that was a moment which was strange, but now let's have a look at the continuation. Now I will keep the normal speed, and let's hear him, because now I just stop for a second. Now he starts to comment. This is a difference compared to our game where he spoke very little, and frankly I was shocked when I was listening to this comment. Well, basically after rook d1, black is completely lost. I mean, like, completely. So now let's see.
Wait, it looks like I might be winning here if I'm careful. I have knight b5 as a candidate move. Let's not take too long.
Well, it's obviously the best one.
Calculate c4.
Yeah, he's calculating c4, but knight b5 is just resigns after knight b5.
Yeah, no, c4 doesn't work. Okay.
It's pretty obvious.
Knight b5 then.
Again, you see some short glances all the time, somewhere. And now this is really funny when I was, because it's obvious white is completely winning. C4 is threatening, and well, basically there is no moves. It's just time to resign. He plays queen e7. It doesn't matter. Computer already gives up a piece, like developing bishop. C4, castles just gives up the piece and plus three or something. Only plus three, because after move
knight a5,
which is
knight
played,
a7.
Yeah, knight a5, knight a5, knight xc7. Not so difficult to see. Now they cut a bit because he's sitting.
I'm trying
waiting.
To find a move against queen e7.
Yeah, that is funny. Queen e7 was played, actually, yeah.
I have some promising lines there, but I don't see
it. Yeah, that is funny. Promising lines. I mean, after queen e7, let's say, first of all, I can assure you, even without any engine, it's very obvious white is completely winning. I mean, I can tell you how much winning is it. After queen e7, first 10 lines are more than plus 4 for white. First 10. Including after queen e7 moves h3 and h4 are also plus 4. First
he's using
five,
a blotter clock here. I don't see a move for him.
First 5 lines plus 5. Just to explain you how winning is this position.
Simply don't see him. I mean, he might have to move his... No, but even if he moves his knight, it's bad. He might have to play knight e5.
Okay, he finally
played. So I have c4, knight e6. Then he gives up his queen and it's obviously not winning.
Well, to start with c4, knight b4, knight c3 is winning, bishop f4, every move is winning. Also, taking the queen is completely winning, of course, for white, which is obvious, but I agree, it's not the most... I mean, knight a3 plus 6, knight d2 plus 5 and half, bishop f4 plus 5. I mean, any move, it's just completely gone, the position, yeah? Okay, whatever, yeah, you play. So let's
there's
listen
92
to the comment.
In the game. I don't give a damn, I'm gonna play it. I don't give a shit.
Again, you see this glances. Well, knight d2 is the first line together with knight a3. Both moves plus 6. I mean, this, it's like I was looking at this, listening, and I don't understand. Like, okay, is that, no, okay, let me play knight d2. I mean, normally you're as a strong grandmaster, you just say, well, it's obvious, I'm completely winning, it's just a question of not to make some stupidity, yeah, but it's completely over the game. It's clear to any strong player, yeah, so he doesn't really see it, and then he's like playing knight d2 as if it's a very brave, risky move. Well, any move wins. Knight d2 is good, yeah. Now glancing, and then he says knight e3 was also good. Very interesting, okay. Mm-hmm. Where is he looking all the time? I mean, can you explain it, Dania? Can you explain, where are you looking? Your monitor is here, it's obvious. It is not the monitor, it is not the clock, and anyway, there is no point to look at the clock so much. Where are you? Chat is there. What is this?
Trust myself. Knight a3 again. Was also possible. The good thing about this move is I have two.
Again, he's looking there. I don't understand. Camera or what? Why you really care about looking at the camera all the time? Then you look all the time, not like glancing there. Okay, he's saying knight a3.
Two directions I can go in.
Yeah. I mean, after watching this video, I started to be really like, okay, this has to be checked carefully. And that's also the reason why I wrote to chess.com. And well, if you're unbiased, I guess you will agree with me that this is all very strange. So it has to be very seriously examined, obviously. So let's see further.
I'm gonna keep the pressure going on his clock.
Well, this is also kind of ridiculous. Why you need to keep the pressure going on his clock when you're plus six, like with any move? Just finish the game. There is nothing to play anymore. So why do you need to play for time? But okay, let's continue. Now he's looking there. I mean, he's playing the decisive game. He just needs to finish it, and he's like looking at the chat or whatever it is. Different sides telling very strange things. I mean, here, well, okay, it's pretty obvious knight e4 just winning, but very interesting. For some reason, engine says knight c4 the first line. Both moves like plus six and something. c4 is plus five. I mean, any move wins. Knight e4 is much more logical, just to keep the option to play c4, and it resigns immediately, but actually knight c4 is also resigns.
If I go here,
plays knight c4, then glances, and then he says, I should play knight e4. Well, it doesn't matter, actually.
Should have gone e4. I should have gone knight e4. Because that was sloppy.
What do you mean sloppy?
Very sloppy.
Plus six. I mean,
I'm just going to keep playing fast. No worries. I'm still winning.
Again, still you winning. See this glances, permanent glances.
Damn.
I don't quite even understand where is the board. I mean, I think it's obviously there, but I mean, at least it was there in the previous game, obviously somewhere there. Now it's like he's almost spending half time looking on the other side.
Okay. World. Oh, he has this move.
Yeah, that is incredible. Yeah, because he's playing rook e1 check. Okay,
Kurizaga is unbelievably tricky though, so let's just continue playing like
that. Yeah, rook e1 check, and he says king d8, black plays, and Dania says, oh, there is this move, but there is no other move. There is simply no, it's otherwise you immediately lose. Yeah, bishop e7, knight d6 check, you lose the queen. Knight e5, knight d6 check, you also lose the queen. King d7, knight takes e7, you lose everything. Okay, it's absolutely only move. And now when, of course, quickly is opponent playing this absolutely only move, which doesn't save, of course, not even close the position, Dan is like he's like miss this move.
I don't give a damn. The freaking world. Oh, he has this move.
I mean, you know, I'm sorry, I'm a professional player. This is like, what is this level? I don't understand. How can you miss king d8? And also now, I mean, like, again, bishop e3, c4, bishop f4, all moves are like plus 7 for white. It's totally gone.
I don't care. Go out here.
And white has 2 minutes still against 42 seconds. All the time, as you see, glancing there, I don't know where. I mean, it's all just, I don't know, what do you think about it? I mean, I'm like, yeah, I find it strange. Let's put it mildly.
Made him.
Okay, but that is just the beginning. Again, you see all the time.
B4 is in my pocket?
B4 is in my pocket, correct. B4 wins on the spot, plus 10, I think. After B4, it's plus 10. But again, any other move, rook e2 even plus 5. I mean, like any move, absolutely any, is winning. And he almost manages to spoil this position. I mean, what is this level? I just played 3 minutes ago. I played with an absolutely top player who played fantastic game. I mean, incredible moves finding in with a short time. And now he just cannot, like, I mean, he's still playing good moves. Well, looking there all the time. But, I mean, he cannot explain anything. I mean, you know, it's a bit weird.
Takes bishop d6 is supposed to work.
Takes b4. Again, all moves plus 7, you know, here. h3 you can play if you want. I mean, it's very obvious to any, even average master, you know, or like 2,200 players, that position is completely lost for black. But okay, let's see.
Where's the win here? There is a win, I'm sure. Where
yeah,
is
mean,
it?
Okay, he takes bishop d6, it's also a win. Yeah, also
get
wins.
Nervous here.
But how can you become nervous here? Well, when you're nervous, you maybe don't look also on the side. How can you become nervous when you're plus 7 with like 5 different moves? It's just kind of absurd. Okay, let's see. I mean, I can tell you, this job is for any like 2500 player, it's like automatic. It's, you don't even like quickly you finish the game, because it's impossible to go wrong here. There is no option to go wrong. I mean, like, any move you play is winning. Okay. Now he's again, it's his move, he starts to look somewhere there. What, he's looking at chat, it's important game. I don't know, where is he, what is this, what is all this?
A7 doesn't work.
And he's like as if he's reading something. I mean,
how is this not just?
But at the same time, he's not answering. If it's a chat, then you would answer. First of all, you don't read it when it's your move. Then you would probably answer something. I don't understand. It just doesn't. Nothing fits here. The level is good. He played till the end. It was 97 level. Not that it was too difficult. I mean, frankly, anyone would make 97 here. So it's not the point. The point is that the behavior, the explanations, and how nervous he got at the end when it was just like, you know, there was nothing to play anymore very quickly after the opening.
Okay, over on the spot. Look at this position.
C4 wins now. On the spot, very easy, but okay.
56, he moves his king.
So it takes 57. A lot of time now. I don't know what for, okay. Because, like, again, okay, we'll
just can think a little bit longer. I mean, he has to think here.
Yeah, bishop d6.
I don't see a move for him again, yeah, but I'm sure he has one and he's gonna find it, so we have to be precise here.
Again, by the way, it doesn't give a single variation. I mean, like, when you calculate, you at least give, okay, if this, this, but just some general words, okay.
Queen okay, d7. Rebuilding the time advantage here, rook d8, I have rook
d5. Rebuilding time, why do you need time when you are plus 6? You know, you don't need, okay.
Yeah, he doesn't see a move either. He goes queen d7, which I saw.
Well, if you saw, why didn't you tell it, but okay. Yeah, rook d5, again, one of winning moves, doesn't matter. It's taking so much time to play a very simple move like rook d5, okay.
Queen e6, he might probably play. I have to watch the back rank, mate.
Yeah, that's
okay.
Amateur.
Obviously, I screwed this up, but I'm...
Absolutely not, he didn't screw this up, it's plus 7 still with any move again. Queen d1 on the spot wins, b4 on the spot, every move wins on the spot. Okay.
Still
okay,
winning.
Queen c4 also.
B4 maybe? Plays.
Yeah, b4 as well, I mean, like, any move.
See, I mean, b4 is a little bit...
Yeah,
iffy.
Yeah, I wouldn't play b4, I agree. Queen d1.
What if I go like that? No, shit, good. Then he's gonna knight. Then I have bishop c4.
But, I mean, he's taking so much time. He's top 5 player, clearly. Yeah? I mean, in Blitz and according to previous game, why he's taking so much time? I mean... for what? It's like any move wins, and he's getting very nervous also, as if it's very complicated position. He has 1 minute against 9 seconds, completely winning position with any move, and he starts to get nervous. So nice. Check.
It's so how does he figure out a move here?
Yeah, okay, queen e6 only move, obviously takes, well, it's completely winning. Yeah, I check, loses, so anything loses, knight e5, yeah. Okay, now again, anything win. I mean, knight d6 check is winning on this spot. Also, rook d7 check wins, whatever, yeah. Okay, he's still some glances from time to time.
Not the way.
I don't know if he's nervous or pretends to be nervous.
Where is it?
I mean, it's very simple, yeah, the position. So he wants to blunder now. No, knight d6 check, king g8. Oh my gosh, but what? What else? I mean, queen takes d6, rook takes e5, immediately resigned. So, I mean, what? Now, by the way, the funny thing is that any actually square where queen goes, I mean, not like, yeah, not completely crazy like g4, is winning. Queen b5, queen b3, queen f1, queen e2, queen e4, all moves are completely winning. Only queen d4 is plus 1. Only plus 1 after queen d4, every other move is plus 5 or something. And now you see, I mean, again, Dani gets extremely nervous here. I mean, it's just like, he wants to play queen d4 is the only move which is not winning on this spot.
Where's the freaking win?
I mean, I can assure you, I'm a chess player, this is so simple, this thing is so incredibly simple, this position, to win. I mean, like, you know, if you are such a brilliant player, like you finish it in a second.
Where's
yeah,
the freaking
win? Okay.
Where is the win?
Any move is a win. Queen e4 is the most obvious, just resigns on the spot. Very
can...
obvious. Okay, why?
And I can
D4?
Play it no shit. What do I do here?
Getting nervous to 20 seconds. Okay, I don't know if it's spectacle. Is it a spectacle or what? Because it's like, you know, again. any, you know, 2000 level player would just find 2200, okay, would find queen e4. But in fact, because rook is hanging, also queen e2, queen f1, every move is winning. But queen f4, of course, obviously finishes it on the spot. So I don't know if it's all spectacle or he's really like cannot, just calculate a single variation, but he was just few minutes ago capable of doing it with a precision, finding queen h4 check, such an incredible tactics like queen h4 check, a really difficult one. And now, yeah. Finally, with 15 seconds, he finds. Mm-hmm. Yeah, rook no, queen d5, rook c8, by the way, first line, queen d5 check, second line. Queen d5, of course, is more logical. It's winning. Okay, so, yeah,
now. Panic. I just sat there until I found the win.
Yeah, he's very happy about this game, that he didn't panic. There was no reason to panic. It was never like less than plus five, yeah, after the opening. So what is all this? I just, all these glances, all those explanations, I mean, this just doesn't fit with the level of the game. And again, now I would like to show you another examples as well, where it's just like, he's playing extremely well, extremely strong chess, but his, amount of glances somewhere up, as I already mentioned, okay, if this is your monitor, this is clearly outside of the monitor. The chat is here. Where are you looking at? I don't understand, especially permanently all the time, including when you have few seconds left. This is like, I would really like to get some explanations from Chess.com, from Naroditsky, what is all this? So, okay, that I am going to show you right now.